Good morning, children. I hope you have revised all the earlier taught chapters, and although we were revising all the chapters daily. So, student, keep practicing all the questions properly. Now, today I will start the new chapters. This is very important, profit and loss. This is very important chapter, children. So, pay full attention towards the student and well studying in the class, and also do complete the given classwork, students. This is also important for the examination point of view. So, study well. I hope you all are familiar with the topic cost price, selling price, profit and loss. So now, first of all, I introduce the what is the cost price and selling price. Now, first the cost price. The price which a buyer purchases an article from a seller is called cost price. Selling price, the price at which a seller sells an article to a buyer is called the selling price. The short form is the S.P means SP. Now, first of all, a shopkeeper generally buys goods from a wholesaler and sells them to his customers. He buys things from the wholesaler at a certain price and sells them to his customer at the another price. So, this process, he either makes a profit or loss. So, all the students, you know that what is a profit? So, a seller makes a profit if the selling price for him is more than the cost price for him. Means the profit is the differences between the selling price and the cost price. Means you have to find out the profit is equal to SP minus CP. And sometimes you have to find out the SP, so CP plus profit. And CP you have to find out SP minus profit. For example, CP of a bar of chocolate is rupees 10 and the selling price is rupees 12 for the shopkeeper. So means the shopkeeper makes a profit, means selling price is greater than the cost price. So profit is equal to 12 minus 10 is equal to 2 rupees is profit. All of you clear, children? Now loss. If the cost price of an article is greater than the selling price, the seller suffer a loss. The means loss is equal to CP minus SP. Means you have to find out the SP, so CP minus loss, and CP you have to find out SP plus loss. For example, the cost price of a toy is rupees 80 and the selling price is rupees 75 for the shopkeeper. The shopkeeper suffer a loss. So loss is equal to 80 minus 75 is equal to 5. Now you have to find out the profit percent. So you use the formula. Already in the formula is given in your books. So just you see in your books very carefully. So profit percent is equal to profit by CP into 100. And loss percent you have to find out loss by CP into 100. Now any percentage will be given profit and loss. So you will use the formula SP 100 plus gain by 100 into CP. And CP you have to find out 100 by 100 plus gain percent into SP. Now exercise 11A start. Question number 1 is here. Find the SP when. Now CP is given 950 and gain is 6%. So find the SP formula 100 plus gain percent by 100 into CP. All the student write the formula. Necessary you have to write in your copy. Otherwise in your exam your marks will be deducted. So you must write the formula. So SP is equal to 100 plus gain. So 100 plus 6 by 100 into 950. You cut very carefully and you find out we get the rupees 1007. Now another question is the same is here, but the gain is the mixed fraction. So be careful all the student.
CP is equal to 9600 and gain is 16, 2/3% means 50/3%. So SP is equal to 100 plus gain percent by 100 into CP. So 100 and gain percent is 50/3 into 9600 means this is 50/3 in the fraction, so by 1. So it is 3 is the LCM and 300 plus 50/3 by 100 into 9600. So 350/3/100. This is the fraction form, so it is by 1 also is here. So this is here reciprocal, 350/3 into 1/100 into 9600. You will be cancel is here and we get is 11,200. Now third question is same is here. The CP is given 1,540 and loss is 4%. Just you see the formula, the SP is equal to 100 minus loss percent by 100 into CP. So 100 minus 4 and 96 by 100 into 1540. So we get rupees 1478.40. Question number 2 is here. Find the gain and loss percent. So CP is given 2400 and SP is given 2592. Means just SP is greater than the CP. So means this is here gain. So gain is equal to SP minus CP. So 2592 minus 2400, we get 192. Now you find out the gain percent. Gain percent formula is equal to gain by CP into 100. So 192 by 2400 into 100. So we get 8% profit. Now the second question is here, the CP is given 1650 and the SP is 1452. Just you see the amount very carefully. This is here, the CP is greater than the SP, means this is here loss. So 1650 minus 1452, so loss is equal to 198. Now loss percent, so loss by CP into 100, so 198 by 1650 into 100, so we get 12%. Now rest of the question I have left for your practice. You will do it by your own. All the student, you clear all of you? Question number 1 and 2, all in the classwork you do it. Okay, bye. Thank you.